described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Learning Zone Express presents Sleepless in America.
Would you like your sleep to be better?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you feel tired during the day?
Not really. I mean, when I first wake up, I do, but after that, not really.
Do you find yourself forgetful?
No.
No? Okay. Would you ever, do you ever have accidents, like you stumble or trip or fall or?
Yeah.
Alone.
Sleep deprivation can look like irritability. It can look like depression. It can look like clumsiness. It can look like poor performance, poor grades. It can look like appetite issues. It can look like difficulty falling asleep.
Eighth grade student, Claire.
I had just been getting into junior high in my seventh grade year, and I was immediately not getting enough sleep. So because of this, I was wondering, are there things to do to help my sleep quality so that it's not the number of hours I get, but more the quality I get so that I wouldn't be as tired? Well, what I did is there's a homeroom class that's 20 minutes in my school, so I decided that I would do a survey during this. So I contacted our office and our assistant principal, and I was able to set up a time that we could try this. So I gave a basic survey asking, like, how many hours of sleep you get and basic questions like that. And I was able to get it to 510 kids. I think what was most interesting was that kids weren't aware of how much sleep they should be getting. They didn't know. Because, I mean, it's one thing to know you should be getting 9 to 11 hours, but you're only getting 6 to 7. That's one thing, but only thinking you need 8 hours of sleep, I think that knowledge is important, and not having that can affect how much sleep you allow yourself.
Mary.
It's estimated that only 15 to 20% of kids are getting the sleep that they need, which means that 80 to 85% are not.
My bus arrived at 7, so I had to get up at around 6 or 6:30, which I was used to school starting at 9:30, so it was a really big difference for me, and the homework caused me to stay up later. So I was going to bed at 11 or midnight and getting up at 6. That really wasn't enough sleep for me, and I knew it.
Claire walks with a friend down a road. Mary.
Many behaviors that are viewed as adolescent irritability actually are an exhausted teen. They're inflexible, more argumentative, not able to problem solve.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.